Hello, students. I'm so sad I can't be there today. Last week, you started your Picasso piece. Not last week. Last time I saw you, you started your Picasso piece. And you left it with a blank face. So you had a big face with no eyes, no mouth. But you did color in and draw your neck, your shirt, crazy ears if you wanted to, and your hair. This week, we are going to finish it by adding eyes, nose, and mouth. You have the option to do whatever you would like for the eyes, nose, and mouth, and you could have them like in weird spots. Like if you wanted, you could put your mouth on your forehead, like whatever. This is Picasso. He did some crazy stuff. So I am going to show you what the next steps are after you have done this. After you've done, you got your blank face. I'm actually going to use this example. You are going to, when your teacher says, go up to the brown table in the front of the room by the chalkboard, and you are going to pick four different squares or rectangles. I guess they could be all the same color or they could be different. Then you're going to go back to your seat. When your teacher says it's time, you can begin. The supplies you will need today is a pencil, a Sharpie, crayons or color pencils, and the last thing you will need is a glue bottle. You will first, I already have one eye done, you will draw in pencil your eyes, nose, and mouth. There's a eyes on one, eye, nose, mouth, okay? Don't know if I made that clear. You can do whatever kinds of eyes. You could do normal ones, I guess, but that's kind of boring. I would rather you do crazy ones. That sounds like fun. So, you draw your features in pencil first. Then you'd go back on top with Sharpie. And you know the Sharpie rules, nice and slow on the pencil road. Whoever is your teacher today is also a Sharpie police person. They are making sure you're staying on the road and driving Grandma nice and slow. So once you have Sharpied, the next step is to add color to your features. You can, this doesn't work, construction paper and markers don't work all that well. That's why I recommend crayons or colored pencil. And there we go. So now I'm done with Sharpie. Now I'm going to add some color. I'm taking my time. It's looking good. I'm going to have some green lips because that's just crazy. Okay. And then maybe my eye has red inside. This looks like a flower more than an eye. Coloring it all nice and good. When you are done with the color, I would like you to spend more time on the color compared to what I did, but I don't want you to look at me and watch this forever. So you're going to color it, add color, then you are going to glue it. I know you're thinking, I have used a glue bottle before. Hold on. I have fifth graders that say, Miss Henning, it's not working. Why isn't it working? Aha, it's not even open. You gotta twist it open. So I like to say, dot, dot, not a lot, so I do a dot, dot, maybe one in each corner, one in the middle maybe. Do not put your dots all the way on the very edge because when you put it down, just glue will come off. I can tell, even though I'm not there, when you put globs, rivers, ponds of glue. That makes me sad. So then you're going to flip it over, put it on your face, count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. It's on there pretty good. Then keep going. We're going to glue our nose. I'm going to have my face like all together, but my mouth will be like on the side. When you are done with your glue, we'll do it like this. Nice. When you are done with your glue, can I throw it back in that black basket now? No. Close it up. Now you can set it standing up in that black basket. Your piece, since there's wet glue on it, it needs to go on a drying rack. And that is as far, and that's what I need you to get done for today. If you are like, ooh, I want to add some more to the hair or to the shirt, go ahead, please do that. Good luck, I can't wait to see it.